urinary tract infection. Urinary tract infection is a common bacterial infection in children and infants. A urinary tract infection or UTI is an infection from microbes. These are organisms that are too small to be seen without a microscope. Most UTIs are caused by bacteria, but some are caused by fungi and in rare cases by viruses. UTIs are among the most common infections in humans. A urinary tract infection can happen anywhere in our urinary tract. Our urinary tract is made up of kidneys, ureters, bladder, and urethra. Most UTIs only involve the urethra and bladder in the lower tract. However, UTIs can involve the ureters and kidneys in the upper tract, although upper tract UTIs are more rare than lower tract UTIs. They are also usually more severe. Incidence. UTI is the second most common infection in children. It is more common in male neonates than female. After first year of life, the incidence is more in girls than boys because of short female urethra and its proximity to anal opening. This ratio is 1800 of girls and 2 in 100 of boys. Etiology. The most common organisms causing urinary tract infections are bacteria like Escherichia coli. 80% of the reason is Escherichia coli. The other gram-negative pathogens include Klebsiella, Proteus, Enterobacter, Citrobacter, and gram-positive Staphylococcus, Enterococcus, and Staphylococcus aureus. Staphylococcus aureus is very rare. Viruses, adenovirus, enterovirus, and fungi, Candida species, Aspergillus species, Cryptococcus neoformus, and endemic Myocos. Viral UTIs are usually limited to the lower urinary tract infections. Classification of urinary tract infection. There are two classifications are there: lower urinary tract infection and upper urinary tract infection. Lower urinary tract infection includes infection of the urinary bladder, known as cystitis, and urethra, is known as urethritis. And upper urinary tract infections, it's include infection of the kidneys, renal pelvis, and renal parenchyma. Risk factors. One of the most significant risk factors for the development of urinary tract infection is any condition or alignment that inhibits or impedes the flow of urine. Anatomic abnormality means obstruction. Obstruction to the urine flow anyway along with the urinary tract, causing urinary stasis and less water intake and frequent voiding. Pathophysiology. Pathophysiology divided into two: ascending and descending. Descending is a hematogenous and the other one is the ascending. See the chart. Hematogenous route: chronic infection of skin, respiratory tract, GA tract. Because of this infection, the Staphylococcus aureus, Salmonella species, Candida species, these infectious agents making infection. This infection is entered to the blood circulation. So the blood circulation from the blood enters to the kidney for the filtration. At the time, the bacteria move from cortex to renal medulla and it leads to bacteriocytes and proliferates. This is the one where two infectious agents are entering to the body. Another way of infectious agents entering to the body, that is means the ability of the host defense decreases or urinary mucosa cells is damaged. Once the ability is decreased, otherwise the urinary mucosa cells is damaged. So the bacteria adhere to periurethral tissues of urethra. In case of the ability is decreased or mucosa cells is damaged, that time the bacteria enter into the urethra. From urethra, bacteria have reached to the bladder and quickly multiply there. And bacteria further migrate to ureters through bladder. And finally, bacteria gain access to renal medulla through renal pelvis. That is the another way. Once the defense is decreased or mucosa cells is damaged, that is the time the bacteria enter into the urethra. From urethra, it is passing to bladder. From bladder, through urethra, reaches the kidney. These are the two ways of pathophysiology. Clinical features of urinary tract infection: a strong or persistent urge to urinate, a burning sensation when urinating, passing frequent small amount of urine or few drops of urine, urine that appears cloudy, urine that appears red or brick pink or cola colored, a sign of blood in the urine is that is. Then strong smelling urine or foul smelling. Then pelvic pain, nausea, vomiting, then diarrhea, fever, irritability, chills, poor feeding, abdominal tenderness, then incontinence. Incontinence means loss of bladder control, varying from a straightness of urine after sneezing or coughing, then laughing, to complete inability to control urination, then microscopic hematuria. Diagnostic evaluation: first one, history collecting, taking the history with detailed clinical manifestations, then physical examination, urine test, then that urine analysis and urine culture and clean catch sample, then ultrasound is a non-invasive imaging test that can be used to screen for hydronephrosis or obstruction of the flow of urine. That's the use of ultrasound in here. That means ultrasound, here we are using ultrasound for identifying the obstruction of the urine. Then x-rays, special x-rays can be used to screen for structural abnormalities, urethral narrowing or incomplete emptying of the bladder. Due to the possible risk of this fetus, x-rays are not performed in another cases. Then voiding cystourethrogram, it is an x-ray of the bladder and urethra. To obtain a cystourethrogram, a dye called contrast material is injected through the catheter, inserted into the urethra and passed through the bladder. How come? See, it is injected, that's the dye is injected through the catheter and inserted into the urethra and passed through the bladder and taking the x-rays. Then next, intravenous pyelogram or IVP. It is an x-ray of the kidney. For the pyelogram, the contrast matter is injected into a vein and eliminated by the kidneys. In both cases, the dye passes through the urinary tract and reveals any obstructions or abnormalities on x-ray images. Then cystoscopy. Cystoscopy is used to detect structural abnormalities, interstitial cystitis, or masses that might not show up on X-rays during an IVP. The patient is given a light anesthetic and the bladder is filled with water. The procedure uses a help of cystoscope and flexible tube-like instrument that the urologist inserts through the urethra into the bladder. Then CT, computed tomography. A computed tomography or CT scan may be used to check the kidney stones or the obstructions. Then last one, blood cultures. Symptoms are severe, the doctor will be ordered blood culture to determine the infection is in the bloodstream and threatening other parts of the body. These are the diagnostic evaluations. Management. Management of urinary tract infection is typically involved pharmacological therapy and patient education. The nurse teacher the patient about medications, regimens and infection prevention measures. First one, acute pharmacological therapy. Uncomplicated cases, single dose of administration of short duration, that is 3 to 4 days regimens or 7 to 10 days are regimens. The antibacterial agent should be affordable and should have few adverse effects. Most cases are cured after 3 days of treatment. Then long-term pharmacological therapy. Relapse of UTI suggests that the source of bacteria may be the upper urinary tract or the initial treatment was inadequate or administered for a too short time. Then patient education. The following measures are the study suggests may reduce the incidence of urinary tract infections. This may be appropriate for the people, especially the mothers need to know. Do not delay the urination when it is necessary. Or second point, a high fluid intake is essential. Then cleaning of urethral meters. Then drinking too much water or other fluids and cranberry juice and often long course of low dose antibiotic can able to use. Nursing management assessment. History of signs and symptoms related to urinary tract infection is obtained from the patient with suspected UTI. Then the presence of pain, frequency, urgency and hesitancy and changes in urine are assessed and documented and reported. Then patient's knowledge about prescribed antibacterial medications and preventive health care measures is also be assessed. Complications, recurrent infection. Recurrent infection, especially in the girls who experienced two or more UTI in 6 months period or four more within a year. Then permanent kidney damage from an acute or chronic kidney infection due to untreated UTI. Then urethral narrowing. Then sepsis, a potentially life-threatening complication of infection, especially in the infection work is way up in the urinary tract to kidneys. Special nursing care and prevention. A complete history of the child is collected, including history of urinary systems. Then physical examination. Then a clean catch midstream urine sample collection, encourage fluid intake, document intake and output. Check daily weight of the baby. Assess the renal function. Palpate and perfuse the bladder after voiding to evaluate bladder empty. Educate the parents to give slightly acidic foods like apple juice, orange juice. If the child is having incontinence of urine, reassure the parents and child. Tell them that the problem is due to infection and it will disappear when infection is cured. Prevention, bathing and hygiene, clothing, dietary and fluid intake, and bladder care. Bathing and hygiene. Shower should be encouraged rather than tub bath. Personal hygiene should be maintained. Children should be thought about keep the genital area clean. Then clothing. Avoid tight fitting clothing, especially the undergarments. Underwear should be changed at least once a day or as soon as it gets soiled. The child should be made to wear cotton panties. Then dietary and fluid intake. Encourage the child to drink plenty of food. Children should be given orange juice, lemon, apple juice like that. And children should not be given fluid that irritate the bladder like coffee or tea. Then the last one, bladder care. Children should be asked not to hold urine for long time. They should pass urine as soon as an urge of urination is felt. Here he discussed about urinary tract infection or UTI. In here, definition, incidence, etiology, classification, risk factors, pathophysiology, clinical features, diagnostic evaluation, treatment and prevention. Thank you.